As you might know, the products currently exist for about 5 years. And since that time, we've introduced quite some new functionality. So today, I'm going to discuss only the latest developments on the products regarding version 8.2, which has been released only just a week, containing, amongst others, support of Visual Server 2016, of course. And we also introduced, actually, in the version before, version 8.1, an advanced tracking manager. We'll see that, of course, in a minute. And further, we added some more capabilities, which most of them I'll show afterwards. Besides Mistral 360, we are pushing some more products to the market. We have about a month ago we have introduced Mistral 360 Cloud, which is actually a lightweight version of Mistral 360 in Windows Azure. And finally, even last week, we introduced Service Bus 360. Which enables you to monitor your service bus queues in Windows Azure. So I'm going to have a look at all these problems, products. We'll start with version 8.2 of Mistral 360. And as I said, my name is Lex Hecht, and I'm not from UK, I'm from the Netherlands, so I could also do this talk in Dutch. Would you like this? No? Jammer. Okay, so let's just continue in English, of course. Yeah, so we have support of Bistock Server 2016, which was released, about a month ago. And we already did support the CTP1 version in version 8.1 of Bistock 360. And as of the release of last week, we also support the RTM version of Bistock Server 2016. We actually wrote an installation manual when you're going to install 2016 or your own local virtual machine. You can download it on that link there, and it's been written by Sandro. Besides that white paper, there's many other documents to find, ebooks, white papers. Amongst other, you already are familiar with this book also from Sandro. It's about 400 pages, all about mapping. So as a BizTalk developer, it might be handy to have that book at hand. So far for the support of BizTalk Server 2016, let's proceed to the Advanced Tracking Manager. As you might be aware of, we already had a feature to be able to have a look at all your tracking settings. We have extended that with also being able to configure all those tracking settings bulk-wise, just by using these buttons there, or per application. So you can configure it per artifact, actually. So we do that for BizTalk applications. But also, there you are. But we can also do it for BizTalk rules. You can already see that on that tab page. Where is it? The screen's a bit dark. Yeah, here it is. So all these settings, you can just manage them from BizTalk 360. So you have one reason less to use the BizTalk administration console on your server. Next, we have introduced queue monitoring, both for Microsoft message queuing as for Azure Service Bus Queue. You need less context switching as one of the main things we like to provide being one platform, so you only need one to administer and monitor your BizTalk environment. And as said, you can just use BizTalk 360 to monitor the health of your queues and your service bus queues. And well, later on we'll see the monitoring we have for service bus queues here. We also have that other product, Service Bus 360, which I'm going to talk about later. Which makes possible to add even more monitoring, all kind of parameters you can monitor with Service Bus 360, which is not possible with BizBox 360, well, this version. And of course, well, it's a monitor, so you can just set your alarms on it and receive your notifications in the way you normally do. So most of the times that will be by email. And there we have the Azure Service Bus monitoring. As of, I believe it was version 8.0, it's also possible when you're working with Logic Apps or API apps to monitor the states of your Logic API apps in Azure, if they are started, and if not. And I believe there's even auto healing on these artifacts. Sarvana, is that right? Not yet. Further, we have extended the feature of monitoring web endpoints. Monitoring web endpoints, that was already possible many releases ago, but we have improved that capability a lot. It's possible, to enter all kinds of specific requests. So maybe you have a certain web service with a certain test operation, so you can easily create a specific message for that for a test web service. You can also, besides GET, you can also use POST operators. You can add all kinds of additional headers if they are necessary. And you can also check for response time alerts. So if it takes too long before the web request is responded, you can get warnings or error notifications about it. Next, we have integration with New Relic. With New Relic, this is just a tool in which you can have a good view of the performing of your BizTalk group. And from BizTalk 360, you can push your environment performance counters towards New Relic. So you have one console, to have a look at all your performance counters. Well, there are some more enhancements we made. They are mentioned here. Well, I won't go through all of them. In the management ESB exceptions, we have added some features. The monitoring dashboard has been improved, so you can directly see what's going on while clicking in a monitoring dashboard. So that's rather helpful. We have improved the Business Rules Composer. In a previous release, there were two menu items, one for the Business Rules Viewer and another one for the Composer. Well, we have reduced that to only one menu option. And we have included the BizBox 360 Troubleshooter, which is mainly helpful, just after you've installed BizBox 360 on your BizTalk group and things might not work as they should. So we had formerly an exe file which you could use and had to download separately, but now we've included BizTalk 360 Troubleshooter in the web application of BizTalk 360. So let's have a look at a number of these features. Where's my browser? Yeah, there it is. Okay, here we have BizBox 360 version 8.2, as you can see here by now. One small addition I didn't mention is this icon. There you can see if a new version of BizBox 360 is available. So from there you can download that new version, get information about the release notes, what's new in that version. And you might install it, of course, but of course there you have to go to the server on which you installed Visual C60. Further, let's move to that tracking manager. Here you have the tracking manager. Take of course some time to load because there are quite some applications in this environment. So here you have all those bulk settings. As you see, you have immediately some buttons to enable or disable the distinct tracking settings. So let's just say, well, we're going to disable all tracking settings for the orchestrations. And it will take some time, and well, it will just turn everything off on that on all the orchestrations. No, I believe I'm not going to wait for that. You know what? We'll see that later on. I just take a new screen and progress to the other options. As mentioned, here in under the operations menu, oh yeah, look, there it is, everything's turned off, and also below, of course, well, I suppose you'll believe me. And besides using these bulk options, you can also configure everything by, well, just navigating to a certain BizTalk application and, well, configure the settings as you like. Just have a look at it. Well, there's not much available here, only on some schemas. So, well, you can just easily turn it on or off. And there you go. Yeah, so that's for one. Okay, yeah, as mentioned, we have here that Business Rules Composer. Besides, that is only one menu item now. You can you have search capabilities both for the policies as for the vocabulary vocabularies which are installed on the environment. So that's quite helpful. Of course, especially when you have a lot of vocabularies. Yeah, well, I suppose you've seen all this before. Yeah, so well, here you have the editor. You can add new policies, add new versions of policies. You can edit them, delete them, publish, deploy. Everything you're used to with the desktop version on this site at least is also possible with the Visual C60 variant of the Business Rules Composer. Yeah, so this for one. What else do we have here? Not in the operation side. So let's move forward. Yes, I want to leave anyway. Let's move forward to the monitoring part. As mentioned, we have all kinds of capabilities regarding monitoring of Azure services. Here you have the capability of monitoring your logic apps and API apps. And it's just, like you're used to, we are creating alarm mappings for all kinds of other artifacts. You just have to mention what the expected state of a certain artifact has to be, and it will be added to the alarm. So let's say, for example, that this logic app has to be disabled. We select it, and we just say the expected state is disabled, it becomes saved, and then it's added to this alarm. And the same goes, of course, for API apps. I'm not sure if there are any API apps in this subscription, but let's just find out. No, not sure if anything's going to happen there. So let's move forward to here, the BizTalk environment, to have a look at those web endpoints here. You can create a new web endpoint for this alarm. And let's say MS from Microsoft. And we say here www.microsoft. And let's take the .com site. Yeah, so you can here enter, which this was already available in earlier releases of BizTalk 360. You can enter credentials, a web service. There might be some authorization around that web service, so you might need to enter the credentials which are authorized to use that web service. You can add that there. Proxy settings was already possible if your organization is using a proxy to communicate with the outer world. You can enter all those details here. And there you have those new features, the payload. Here you can just mention what kind of message you're going to use. Is it going to be a GET or is it going to be a POST? HTTP version, kind of content, and all kind of other additional parameters. Custom headers, which might be necessary to enter. For now, leave it like this. And here we're looking at the response capabilities, where you can just check for certain HTTP codes which have to be returned. Of course, normally you get a 200 if you expect a response. So just enter, I expect a 200, which must be present, and otherwise you can also say the opposite, must be absent, which is a bit strange in this case, but well, you never know. And then you can just say, okay, I want to show a warning or I want to show an error. And if needed, you can add more of this kind of rules. You can also enter certain keywords. Say you just know that the response contains a keyword called success or okay or something like that. You can just enter it here and apply the same kind of rule like we did here. So let's just say it has to be okay, which of course in this case is a rather small word, so that's a bit risky, but let's just do it. It must be present, and otherwise, let's just say we are going to throw an error. And as a final, you can also set alerts on the response times. So if it just takes too long before you get a response, you also can show an error of a warning. Let's not do this and take just this one. Yeah, so there was no okay in this case, so we got an error. So this was it about the web points features. And then we still have the queues left. Here we are. This environment has a message queue, so you can adjust enter a new queue, or in this case, let's just have a look. Let's just click this button and see what we are capable of here. There is already something entered here. Warn me if that letter messages will count equals to 10. And blah blah blah. Then you get a warning, but you can simply configure these thresholds here, or as I said, you can add additional rules. And we can more or less do the same for the Azure Service Bus. You can simply add a new queue. So therefore you need to retrieve the connection string to that service bus, which you can get from the Azure portal. I'm not sure if I have it at hand here. Yeah, there it is. The connection settings. And you just take this connection string and apply it here. Paste. And you need to provide the queue which you are going to monitor. And that, of course, can be seen here. Well, we have only one queue. Oh, clicking wasn't necessary. Let's see if we can copy paste it. Where is it? Oh, no. Well, whatever. You can just enter it here. Save configurations. It's going to check. It immediately gives a warning. It must be because I already applies the same queue before. Current state is active. Yeah, okay, well, looks like fine to me. Interesting. So that's about the queues. Well, I believe that was it regarding BizTalk C60. So let's get back to the slides. And start talking a bit about BizTalk C60 Cloud. Yeah, well, as I mentioned, BizTalk C60 Cloud is the lightweight variant of BizTalk C60. It's a SaaS solution, so it's installed in the Azure Cloud. And well, these are the steps you have to go through to be able to use BizTalk C60 Cloud. You have to create an account. And when you have done that, you need to install a small client on your BizTalk environment. And if that works smoothly, you can just start creating your maps and your alarms, and your notifications, add users, that kind of stuff. And currently, we support four artifacts, as mentioned there. The most important, of course. The ports, the orchestrations, and the host instances, and well, as also mentioned, if you sign up, you get a free description for 10 artifacts, so you can just start using it with those 10 artifacts, and have a look if it works out for you. If it works out for you, well, you can just extend your subscription plan. You need to add your credit card, and upgrade your subscription plan so you can monitor more artifacts than just those 10 you got for free. Besides, an advantage of the cloud variant of BizTalk C60 is you can add multiple environments within the same subscription. That's very, very handy. So you don't need to set up additional accounts if you want to monitor multiple environments. And well, as said, you can just start monitoring, and if it works for you, you can upgrade, and otherwise you can keep it to those maximum of 10 artifacts you're going to monitor. The features, you get a nice overview, consolidated dashboard. And the agent which is installed on your BizTalk environment is constantly communicating with this SaaS solution, so you get constant refreshes of the state of your environment. And as you can also see here, there are already two environments in this account, but you can add as many as you like. Then you have the monitoring dashboard. You can very good compare it with the dashboard you might already know from BizTalk C60. So you got a nice tree view which shows exactly the state of all your artifacts. You get also the notification history. So very good comparable to what you already know from BIS 360 itself. And as the last feature, you can add multiple users and also providing them with different authorizations, of course. Normally you have one or two account owners, people who are also able to change, to make changes to the subscription plan, that kind of stuff. And then you have a super user, which is allowed, somebody who is allowed to change everything in all the distinct environments. And you have a normal user, which is, has a little bit less authorizations, of course. So also here we're going to do a demo. Here we still have BIS 360. And here we have BIS 360 Cloud. As you see by the URL, it it runs in the cloud. Here you have the dashboard. And further, it looks a bit, it gives the same look and feel as you might already know from the new Azure portal. Here can change your plans. Well, let's have a look at it right away. Now I can have maximum 10 artifacts, but if you like, you can modify the plan and just have a look at how many artifacts you would like to have. You can do it on a monthly base, but when you do it on an annual base, it will be a lot cheaper. Yeah, so here you can add additional environments. I won't do that because I don't have an environment at hand. You have to generate a key, which will be supplied in the after you have downloaded that agent and installed it on that BizTalk environment. Then you need to enter this key, which is generated. Luckily, you can just copy and paste that key. So that makes it a bit easier. It's not very funny to having entered this this kind of key by yourself. Here you have the user management. Currently you have two accounts created, two users created. And here you can just enter the details of any other new users and give them the authorization they need. The payment details, changing plan, billing history, etc. And your own account details. Okay. We go back to the dashboard. So currently this agent isn't receiving any information. You get information about that. That's because I run that agent on my local virtual machine, which happens to be turned off. So not very much information at the moment. You get some details about the BizTalk environment. The number of alarms which have been set up, the number of artifacts which have been set up. And from here, you have you can just manage the environment at hand, and as you see, it looks a lot like you already know from BIS 360 itself. You have that monitoring dashboard with the tree view. You can enter alarms at a manage alarm option. And just go through them. Where's my mouse? It's a bit more convenient. Here. Oh, and of course you have the notification history. So apparently there has been something going on quite recently. Here you can create your alarms. It really has the same look and feel as BIS 360 itself. And let me see if I can edit such an alarm. Hey, you can. Here you provide all the details. the person, name of the alarm, who needs to receive the notifications. You can disable the alarm. Well, as mentioned, I suppose you've seen all these screens before, right? Yeah, of course. So you have the threshold settings here, and you have the alarm settings in case you want to receive a daily report, say every business day on 8 a.m. or something like that. So that's the container actually, and then we have the BizDoc applications. There are three BizDoc applications on this environment. Let's take this one. Application contains an orchestration which is being monitored. Let's say that the expected state, let's just say we're not having to monitor it at all. So it just switches, of course. Nothing new. And you can do the same for the other types of artifacts here. Besides the BizDoc applications, you can also go to the BizDoc group, and from there configure how you want the host instance to be in which state. And of course, we want that to be started. So that's really about it. And also this screen, well, we more or less know that you have one a consolidated screen where you can easily delete the mappings you don't need anymore. So far for BizDoc 360 Cloud. And then we go to our last product. The product which we introduced only last week. So it's brand new, actually. Service Bus 360, as mentioned, enables you to monitor your Azure Service Bus queues. And it works the same as BizDoc 360 Cloud. It works based on subscriptions. And well, it has some other advantages, of course, and it gives more monitoring capabilities than the ones you will find in BizDoc 360. And it's also just as BizDoc 360 built around these three pillars: operations, monitoring, and analytics. And I only have to admit that analytics is not yet there, but we are working on that, so that will arrive later. We have a couple of features, of course. Well, you can provide read-only access to the queues, so that also takes away the need to give people authorization to the Azure portal. You can fetch all kinds of messages from your queues. From the monitoring part, there's quite a lot you can monitor on your service bus queues. You can also provide health reports, like we've already seen from BizDoc 360 Cloud. You might also know from BizDoc 360 itself. And as mentioned, later there will be also some analytics information about the use of your service bus queue. And there's here a small demo. That is there. Well, again, you have the same look and feel as the new Azure portal. Here you have a drop-down which contains all the namespaces, the service bus namespaces you have added to your to service bus 360. So you can add multiple service buses, actually. Here are all the distinct features. We'll have a look at that in a minute. Here you have the same capabilities as with BizDoc 360 Cloud regarding the subscription plans, and well, some more information about your current profile. And when you click here, here in this button, on this button, you can associate multiple service buses. And if needed, well, change some settings. The connection string that becomes hidden out of security options purposes. Yeah, so we go back. So here we have that monitoring dashboard. That's for this service bus. So I got an alarm here called queues. And it monitors the state of one topic. And from that topic, you see you have all kind of monitoring. And besides monitoring the topics themselves, you can also monitor for the subscriptions. So if there is a subscription to a topic, well, these are the parameters you can monitor on. And here, of course, you can simply turn everything on or off. By clicking that edit button, you can enter or change the parameters which are entered here. Well, we just keep them like they are. So those were the topics. Here you have the alarms. It's also the same kind of interface we already know from BizTalk 360. The queues. Yeah, here you have the operations. So here you can get messages from that service bus, from this queue. But there's some more. Here you have the monitoring. Yeah, look, these are all the distinct parameters you can set monitoring on. And also, of course, with the editing capabilities afterwards. The topics we have seen, and well, you can also add monitoring for relays and for event hubs. Yeah, I think this is it. And you get here some parameters of those distinct queue. Okay, well, I believe that was it. So, if you have any questions, I would like to receive them. And otherwise, I want to thank you for the attention. Any questions? No? Okay, thank you very much.